plano maghain ng motion ang company Rappler CEO Maria Ressa para ibasura ang kasong cyber libel na isinampa laban sa kanya ng negosyanteng si William Keng. Kaugnay ng reklamo, mga kapanayam natin si National Bureau of Investigation Cybercrime Division Chief Victor Lorenzo. Magandang umaga sa iyo, Mr. Lorenzo.
Magandang umaga din, sir.
Okay, itong cybercrime, it's kind of a new concept, no? Nagkaroon lang ng cyber libel, cybercrime, nag-bloom itong internet, no? So, ano ba yung cyber libel? And is there a difference between cyber libel at itong matagal nang nasa batas na libel?
Dapat sir natin intindihin na meron tayong traditional libel na nasa revised penal code natin. Mm-hmm. Yan din yan, in-extend lang yan sir, mm-hmm. ng ibang format which mm-hmm. became the cyber libel. Pero mm-hmm. ang element sir ng libel under mm-hmm. the revised penal code, yung traditional, are the same mm-hmm. sa cyber libel. It should have yung allegation of a discreditable act that tends to cause dishonor, destroy the name and reputation of anyone. Mm-hmm. Ang element pa niyan, sir, is publication. Dati, sir, sinusulat yan. Right now, ang publication natin is through internet.
Is on, okay, internet is not just websites, no? Okay, before we go to the Maria Ressa case, and she's being, ang complaint laban sa kanya, yung article na lumabas sa Rappler website. Pero most people are doing Facebook, no? And kung ano ng mga sinusulat nila sa Facebook. Yung post and comments on Facebook, ayan din ba? Are people liable for what they say there in terms of itong na cybercrime laws ng ating bansa?
Yes, sir. Under the cyber libel, pagka yung requirement or element ng conventional libel na comply, you could be liable for cyber libel, sir.
So, okay. Halimbawa, you slander someone in a Facebook comment, ang pwedeng reply lang doon sa isang post or reply sa isa pang comment, even that is covered by the law.
Ang cyber libel, sir, would only pertain to the original author of a libelous material, sir.
Okay,
pag sinare mo, finorward mo, hindi ka covered ng cyber.
Okay, so comments are not covered?
Hindi, sir.
So even a comment on a website?
Yeah,
outside,
sir.
Facebook ito, no?
Yes,
on a website. So yes, hindi yun, so you could say whatever you want on as a comment on Facebook. Pwede mo, can you send a death threat to somebody in a comment? Pwede ba 'yon?
Hindi din pwede, sir, kasi may traditional threat tayo.
Iba 'yon, that's not libel.
Yeah, that's not libel, sir.
Okay, that's great threat, yeah, no? Yeah, that's under death threat. Yes, okay. Itong kaso ni Maria Ressa, may mga nagsasabi, well, of course, itong argument ng kanyang lawyer na lumampas na sa yung tinatawag na one-year prescription period, because you were saying cyber libel is just an extension of libel, and under the revised penal code daw, you only have 1 year after publication to file a libel complaint. But this is a complaint filed against Rappler for an article that they published in 2012. So why doesn't the one-year prescriptive period apply here?
Sir, I would not want to talk about the specifics of Maria Ressa's case kasi it's already pending with the court.
So, sub judice. Okay.
Yes. But in general, sir, if mm-hmm. you're going to talk about yung mm-hmm. publication nga, mm-hmm. there are so many legal theories about this. Mm-hmm. Let's go to the traditional libel, sir. Mm-hmm. When a publication is made, pag tinabi mo yung newspaper clippings,
mm-hmm. archive na yan.
Naka-archive na yan. But kapag ang platform mo is over the net, and it could be accessible mm-hmm. by anyone. Mm-hmm. Nag-lapse ba yun, sir? Is it a continuing offense? These are some of the questions that needs to be settled by the court, sir. Pwede nilang i-elevate yan.
That's a relatively new situation.
Yes,
no?
Sir.
Kasi that came with the internet. So in other words, wala pang jurisprudence about that. Anywhere? Like even in other countries, usually kasi yung sinasite ng mga abogado, pag walang jurisprudence dito, US Supreme Court. Eh. Pero dito sa atin, wala.
Wala pa, sir.
So this is a landmark case.
Yes, sir.
Kung ano yung i-decide dito, it's going to be, the whole same principle or doctrine might be applied in other cases.
May mga similar jurisprudence, sir, around the world. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi exactly yung facts ito. Dito, hindi siya. It may have a persuasive effect on how they're going to decide sa issue na to, sir. But mm-hmm. it's still yet to be settled.
Okay, you made a distinction between yung mga lumabas sa dyaryo and then yung mga napapublish online, no? Pero may mga cases. Halimbawa, ako ay naging newspaper reporter ng Manila Chronicle noong 1980s. Wala pa yung internet. Pero yung ibang articles namin naka-archive on the internet. So it's accessible. So is that considered continuous publication? Can I be sued for libel for something I wrote for an analog or a paper newspaper in 1988 if it was republished on the internet as a newspaper archive?
You know, sir, that's yet to be settled. If it will be considered as a continuing offense or at the same time, it's a new publication. Mm. Kasi nag-evolve, sir, ang environment natin.
But that particular situation will be affected by the decision on this RESA case. Tama? Kunyari, yes. Pwede ako maging liable for that kung depende sa decision dito sa RESA case on what constitutes continuous publication.
Yes, sir. That will settle the case, sir, upon the appreciation of the courts.
Okay, itong particular case, can you clarify the sequence of events pagdating dito sa NBI? Because supposedly, in 2018, in February, parang ibinasura na raw ni dating Cybercrime Division Chief Manuel Eduarte yung itong cyber libel case ni Maria Ressa, citing itong lapsed prescriptive period. And then the same year, parang ibinalik, no? Ni-reverse yon. So can you clarify kung ano yung katotohanan dyan? What really happened there and why? If it was reversed, why was it reversed?
Sir, hindi ako kasi makapag-comment. Mm-hmm. First of all, sir, hindi ako privy in the actual investigation of the case. Okay. Ang nakikita ko lang, sir, it was elevated with the court and the court issued a warrant of arrest. Which we implemented.
Okay.
Pero yung nitty-gritty and details on how they filed the case, sir, hindi ako part noon, sir, kasi I was not then the chief of the cybercrime. Okay.
So you did not know anything about this case until very recently.
Hindi ka aware
na may ganitong kaso na pinaiimbestiga sa NBI and then maaring nag-decision na yung NBI to junk the case. Junk the complaint. Wala kayong alam doon.
Hindi ko alam yun, sir. And so far as I am concerned, sir, hindi yan na-junk ng NBI considering that elevated siya sa court, sir. So, the NBI must have filed yung case.
Mm-hmm. Okay, moving on, no? Sa ibang usapin ngayong panahon ng kampanya, nagmo-monitor ba kayo ng cybercrime laban sa fake accounts ginagamit? Of course, social media is a very big factor sa politika ngayon, sa elections, ano? And there's kunyari, yung itong fake accounts, bots, fraud on social media ay nasa sakop ba ng inyong authority to investigate?
Yes, sir. Under the cyber libel, sir, madami kaming complaints coming from even politicians. Mm-mm. Wherein they allege that they are being libeled. Madami kami yan, sir. But in directly monitoring yung entire spectrum ng internet, sir, we could not monitor that, sir.
Okay. Of course, no. So how do you prioritize kung anong iimbestigahan nyo? I mean, obviously, you're paying attention to some, like Maria Ressa's case, no? So how do you choose kung anong ipaprioritize nyo kung napakarami itong mga kasong, itong mga complaints ng cyber libel? How do you choose what to investigate?
Sir, we handle cases one at a time. We follow the principle kasi, sir, yung although madami ang libel na yan, pero we ang principle is that ang pinaka-importanteng case for a complainant is his complaint, regardless kung ano yung complaint na yan, sir. So, kung meron kami, sir, although may mga challenges kami in terms of the volume of work, handle cases one at a time. Kung ano ang nandyan, kung pwede natin imbestigan, kung pwede natin iserve, pwede natin implement, then we handle it one case at a time.
Okay, so dami yung natatanggap na complaints and then requests to investigate, including from politicians, important people, no? Pero ginawa niyong priority yung kaso ni Maria Ressa out of all of these, ano, kasi siya yung, ano, medyo nagpunta pa kayo sa opisina and to serve the arrest warrant and then mukhang talagang inibistigan ninyo and then you gave a recommendation to the Department of Justice. Was she a priority, her case, a priority by the NBI? Sa dami ng mga kaso ninyo.
Hindi actually, sir. In fact, at that time, on that day, dalawa ang cases na hinahandle namin, sir. Not mm-hmm. related to mm-hmm. Maria Ressa, mm-hmm. but within the vicinity. We are investigating.
Okay. And
we
okay. were You were in the neighborhood.
Yes, uh-oh. We were conducting so, a surveillance at that
kasi
time.
Okay, some people noted the timing. Kasi nga, 5 o'clock na raw kayo kumatok doon sa office niya to serve the arrest warrant. Kind of late in the day, no? So hindi siya nakapag-post ng bail, no? And that was not a deliberate decision on the part of the NBI to go there very late in the day.
Wala kaming intention, sir, na uh-huh. to let her stay dito sa NBI mm-hmm. or hold her overnight. Mm-hmm. In fact, sir, we just chance upon her na nandun siya. Mm-hmm. Na may warrant kami, may valid mm-hmm. kami warrant. Mm-hmm. We might as well go past mm-hmm. her office. Mm-hmm. Tapos, nandun siya, sir.
So pag wala siya doon. Yung agents niyo raw objected to having their pictures taken while serving the warrant. Is there kind of a rule about that? Kasi that is a media office. I mean, you would expect, your agent should expect, I guess, if you go into a newsroom or a media office na may video, may cameras doon, may reporters doon na magko-cover ng act na yun. So parang bakit nagalit yung mga ahente ninyo?
Actually, sir, wala naman nagalit. Nagkaroon lang na siguro ng misinterpretation.
They were even threatening daw. There's video recording of kind of a threat by
agents. Misinterpretation lang yun, sir. Kasi natural reaction yun, sir, ng mga field agents na makiusap na huwag mo namang i-publish yan. Kasi, sir, there are ongoing surveillance, ongoing undercover operations. Yung mga regular agents, sir, mga field operatives kasi, sir, yan ang natural tendency nila na makiusap na huwag naman i-publish kasi baka ma-compromise for security.
Ma-endanger yung kanilang trabaho.
Tama yun, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Maraming salamat sa iyong mga paliwanag. National Bureau of Investigation Cybercrime Division Chief Victor Lorenzo.
Maraming salamat.
Thank you.